How you doing? I'm Hank Jansen. I'm the head coach and competitive swim director here at the Marion YMCA. This is Brittany Daniel, and I'll let Brittany introduce herself.
I am the associate aquatic director at the Darien YMCA, but I am also an assistant swim coach for the Piranha swim team here at the Darien YMCA also.
This is a personal profile for Alex Kilko's multi-genre English class project. Alex's swim on the Piranha swim team has been on the team for roughly 5 years.
All right, who does your immediate family consist of?
My immediate family consists of my wife, Michelle, my daughter, Olivia, who is 12, my son, Zach, who is 10, my daughter, Avery, who is 8, and my daughter, Violet, who's actually, excuse me, just turned 4.
When and where were you born?
I was born in the fine city of New Haven, Connecticut. 1975.
And what country did your family come from?
My dad was born and raised in Holland. My mom was born and raised in Poland. My brother and I are first generation Americans.
And what was your childhood like?
My childhood, I think for the time it was pretty normal. It would probably look abnormal now because we were able to be outside all day. We didn't have cell phones, or was all these crazy. We had video games, but not like we have today. And the social media wasn't around, so we'd be out all day, ride your bike all day, play all day, and then you check in, you know, for some food, and you go back out and you play until the lights came on, and that's when you had to come home at night. You know, even up until high school, it would be, you know, go to school, come home, play football, go to swim practice, do homework, go to bed, and start to cycle all over again. So at the time it was pretty normal, pretty run-of-the-mill, but I'm sure it seems a lot now.
Have you experienced any events that significantly shaped you as a person? And if so, what were those events and how have they shaped you?
Wow. I think the events that really shaped me, which was, I wouldn't really call them events at all, but when my dad got me involved in swimming. Obviously, it's been a part of my life it's actually been a part of my life forever, because I always had a pool in my backyard, but as far as it being organized, I started as an organized swimmer at 10, and it's been a big part of my life ever since. So I think the day that he asked me if I wanted to be on the swim team was probably the event that really shaped my life the most, because everything I have now, I feel I've gotten from swimming, or directly or indirectly, so yeah.
Who was or is the most significant person in your life or person you look up to the most?
I would have to say people, my parents. I look up to my parents. They were both working parents. They worked very hard. Like I said, I was a first generation American. It was, you know, their goal to have me and my brother and I, to have a better life than they did, have a better job than they did. I think that was kind of every parent's goal, but, you know, that kind of American dream of, you know, kids going to college like they weren't able to. So yeah, I definitely look up to my parents, both my mom and dad. Biggest role models in my life. Like that.
Is there anything about your life or yourself that you wish you could change or would have done differently, and why?
It's gonna sound pompous, but no, I don't think I would have done anything too differently. There are certain moments in my life I wish I reacted differently. You know, which I said this thing instead of that, but nothing major in my life that I could say that I wish I had done this or I wish I had done that and I wish I was on a different path. I'm one of those believers everything happens for a reason. You make your own choices, you make your own paths in life, and, you know, if I wanted to be different, I would change it. And right now, I don't want it to be different. And I have nothing to complain about, so.
What has your career been like so far?
I'm assuming that's my coaching career. It's been awesome. It really has. I was very lucky to have great mentors growing up. As a young coach, and even to this day, I have great mentors I still look up to, I still talk to. I think it's important. But yeah, I've had a lot of successes, and not just, you know, because I've been lucky enough to have good enough swimmers to make it to some of the biggest meets in our country, but I've just been blessed to have a profession where I get to work with kids regularly, I get to meet great people, I get to help kids start on a healthy, you know, on the way to a healthy lifestyle, and and doing something that I always loved doing, and you know, and I get to do it every day, and I get to make a living doing it. So yeah, it's been awesome.
Well, that kind of answered the next question. Do you enjoy your current job as a swim coach, and why?
Oh yeah, absolutely. Yeah, I think just like I said, you know, I get to work with kids. I've been blessed with meeting a lot of great people, working with a lot of great kids. So yeah.
Why did you decide to become a swim coach?
You know, I started swimming competitively or organizationally when I was 10, and I fell in love with it. I've always loved swimming. I was able to do it through my college years, and I think I knew then I really wanted to be a part of my life, either as a swimmer or as a coach, even if it was part-time. Now I get to do it as a full-time profession, but yeah, I just love swimming so much, and it's given me so much that I want to be a catalyst and an avenue to give it back, you know, to other people and other children. So.
How does being a swim coach affect your personal life? Swim meets, early morning or late night practices, etc.
It's tough. It's tough on the family, definitely, having long weekends and where my wife is stuck with all four kids for hours upon hours, getting home late at night where I can't help so much with homework. It is a little tough. It's probably a little tougher on them than it is me. I do feel bad about it, but it is the profession I've chosen, and it's a profession, like I've said before, it's given me so much. So it's hard to be angry at swimming, I guess, from that standpoint, but it is tough. It is tough on the personal life. I think it's a little tougher on the home life. I'm 45. My personal life is minuscule. So yeah, it's a little tougher on the home life, definitely. But you know, we manage.
What is your opinion on the current state of swimming? Rules and regulations, the way meets are run, etc.
Okay. I'm probably not going to touch so much on rules and regulations, but the state of swimming. At the highest level, swimming in the USA is very healthy in the sense that we have the best swimmers in the world, and we always seem to develop. This country always develops the best swimmers in the world. You know, and I think it is getting faster at every level, which again is not always an indication of how good it's going. I think if you looked over the last couple of years, the numbers have definitely dropped across the board, across the country, with USA Swimming and with swim teams. So I definitely think overall it's great. I think there are some things we do need to change. I think like length of meets was something that was mentioned. I think, you know, with teams and participation dropping a little bit, you know, at the grassroots level, we need to make some changes, I think, definitely. Get the meets shorter. You know, maybe the meets are a little too expensive for some families, even maybe training fees. I think we gotta look at all of it to keep it strong. And so we can still keep that huge base of swimming we have going forward, and so we can still, you know, at the top level, remain to be the, you know, world superpower in swimming. But I definitely think there's some changes that need to be made, you know, at all levels.